Hello and welcome to the last part of this unit about the alkaline electrolysis technology. Here we will discuss about the current market and the future research. Currently, the market can be categorized into three different segments. The small-scale electrolyzer market includes electrolyzers that produce less than 1 normal cubic meter of hydrogen per hour. They are mainly used to replace the storage compressed hydrogen cylinders and bundles. The possibility to produce on-site and on-request high-purity hydrogen is very convenient for numerous applications. For example, fuel gas for flame application or inflation of meteorological balloons. Logically, electric energy consumption of a small-scale electrolyzer is higher than that of large electrolyzers, mainly due to the electrical consumption of the auxiliaries, which is almost the same whatever the size of the electrochemical cell. Furthermore, energy consumption is usually less significant in a small system and reduction of capital expenses is preferred over efficiency. As for the medium-scale electrolyzer market, it includes electrolyzers that produce between 1 and 10 normal cubic meter of hydrogen per hour. They are normally used in the industry sector to produce on-site hydrogen for industrial applications such as metallurgy application, power plant cooling system or food processing industry, and to replace the use of higher hydrogen bundles or tube trailers. Finally, large-scale electrolyzers produce from 10 to more than 100 normal cubic meter of hydrogen per hour. We can highlight here that very large electrolyzers producing hundreds of normal cubic meter of hydrogen per hour have been used to produce ammonia. The real market of such very large electrolyzers is related to the development of hydrogen as an energy vector. This is the case for fuel cell vehicles where car and bus filling stations should be equipped with a large electrolyzer able to produce enough hydrogen to fill the tanks of the fuel cell vehicles. Electrolyzers with hydrogen production capacity ranging from 10 to 100 normal cubic meter of hydrogen per hour perfectly fit with hydrogen needs in a small refueling station, as long as the number of fuel cell vehicles remain low. Moreover, electrolyzers can also be used for the stabilization of the electric grid connected to renewable energy. For each of these three markets, we can see on the slide different manufacturers of this type of systems. In this slide, we can see the three main technologies available on the market. On the left, we find the Oerlikon electrolyzer, which uses large square electrodes. It operates at atmospheric pressure and does not require circulation pumps. On the top, we can see the Norsk Hydro electrolyzer, which is composed of circular electrodes, and it also operates at atmospheric pressure. And finally, the last one is the Lonza electrolyzer, which is a pressurized electrolyzer, and it is composed of large circular electrochemical cells. Let's see now what are the recent trends in the alkaline technology, whose further development has largely been focused on the development of new cell structures and electrode materials. In terms of cell structure, reducing the distance between the electrodes has been a major focus. Devices that narrow this gap, or even removing the gap altogether, have been designed, and this contributes to a reduction in the overpotential. Additionally, increasing the operation temperature can also result in higher efficiency, as we have seen in the previous slides. This increases the ionic conductivity and decreases overpotential. However, the alkaline solution can become more corrosive at higher temperature. Therefore, materials that are more resistant to this condition are required for higher alkaline water electrolysis operation temperature. Among the current advanced designs, we can first mention the use of metal foam as electrodes. This means that the metallic meshes used in zero-gap electrolyzers are replaced by metallic foams. They use Inconel foam on the cathode and silver nanoparticles coated the nickel foam on the anode as gas diffusion electrodes. Even though this structure is far more expensive than that than the conventional one, the use of metallic foams with high surface area as electrodes should be a promising way for high temperature and or high pressure electrolyzers. Another design is the gas diffusion electrodes concept, with gas diffusion electrodes and recirculation of the electrolyte between the electrodes. Its electrode assembly consists of a cell separator, an active layer, a gas diffusion layer, and a nickel net used as current collector. As the electrolyte circulates between the electrodes, the differential pressure between the two gas compartments and between the gas compartments and the electrolyte are crucial. Indeed, if the electrolyte pressure is less than the gas pressure, gas will flow in the electrolyte and the catalyst layer will partly lose the ionic contact with the electrolyte. This will result in an increasing of cell resistance. On the other hand, if the electrolyte pressure is too high, the electrolyte will cross the hydrophobic gas diffusion layer and it will be accumulated in the gas compartments. The first result presented on this electrolyzer saw performance close to conventional filter press electrolyzers, 2.4 volts at 500 milliamps working at 80 degrees Celsius. The last advanced design presented is the ionic exchange membranes, or AEM. In order to further reduce the internal resistance of the electrolyzer and operate the cells at high pressure, the possibility of using a non-porous membrane with high ionic conductivity has also been investigated. The same half-cell reaction takes place in the anion exchange membrane's electrolysis cell as in alkaline water electrolysis. Porous catalytic layers are deposited on each side of the membrane to form a membrane electrode assembly very similar to what is currently used in the proton exchange membrane water electrolysis. Anion exchange membranes already exist and some are commercially available. However, mobility of hydroxide ions is significantly lower than that of protons of the PIM technology, and it is difficult to reach conductivity similar to that of proton conducting membranes. Moreover, many of these membranes still suffer from a lack of chemical stability at high pH, necessary for good ionic conductivity. In addition, it is of major importance to also develop an ionomer compatible with the membrane material and meeting the same requirements in order to produce the catalyst layer. One of the major advantages of anion exchange membranes water electrolysis is the replacement of conventional noble metals electrocatalysts with low-cost transition metal catalysts. Further advantages include the option to discharge hydrogen at higher pressure, the fact that only deionized water or low concentration of alkaline solution needs to be supplied to the electrolyzer, and the use of a low concentration of alkaline solution which eliminates precipitation of potassium carbonates. Furthermore, the absence of a corrosive liquid electrolyte offers advantages such as no leaking, volumetric stability, easy of handling, and a reduction in the size and weight of the electrolyzer. As a conclusion, we can say that anion exchange membrane technology can offer a low-cost electrolytic option. However, membrane durability needs to be significantly improved before competing with PIM electrolyzers. With the explanation of the different points about the alkaline electrolysis technology, we conclude this unit. Thank you very much for your attention.